character design. There. You can click off the video now. No, I'm just kidding. Please stay. I have a family to feed. All right, look. I ain't an art god. I mean, legit, I'm a stupid idiot. Yet even an idiot like me will look at Sonic and scream in fright at the might at this sight. And yet, when I look at Pikachu, he looks so nice. He looks so tender. He looks like a fuzzy, warm boy who needs a home. And yes, there are those awkward screenshots of Pikachu circulating, yet when you look at him in motion, it doesn't really seem that off-putting when compared to Sonic's horrible, just, oh my god. So why is that? Are you stupid? I just said why that is. Yes, character design. It doesn't take a genius to see that this is not a faithful rendition of this. Everyone else's adaptation is far better looking for him than what the people who were overpaid to make this fucking film came up with. See, Hollywood is going through this trend that isn't really new, actually. It's this trend where they think to themselves, holy shit, CG is actually looking good this decade. Oh my god, it's affordable and easy to use. Now, let's pump out as many movies as we can that has CG and act like it's the bestest thing ever. This generation is no different. It doesn't help that rendering CGI is actually better than before and is way more affordable and easier to get into now more than ever. This shit used to be rocket science. Nowadays, any Joe Schmo can look up a tutorial on how to make anything. I made these donuts off of Blender, just off of a tutorial I saw on YouTube, and this is my first time rendering anything in 3D. Yes, I know, thank you. Yes, I do indeed have a massive cock, anyways. With the accessibility of 3D rendering and the potential of making millions of dollars based off of millennials' lust for the good old days, aka the 90s, then of course we are going to lead to movies like Sonic, Lion King, Aladdin, and Detective Pikachu. Yet the thing that seems to be well to the producers behind these movies is the idea that these cartoon characters have to somehow look realistic and superimposed into the real world, and not at all cartoony because they'll somehow look less realistic. Let's face it, that's the mindset behind all these IPs. They have to look realistic because cartoons are for kids and we're trying to be edgier and more realistic for those hip millennial kids because that's what they like. We can't be having these fake ass cartoons running around. That's for babies. It'll never look good in the real world. We gotta make it believable. Give them real fur, real texture, real lighting. Fuck it, hyper-real. Realism is the way of the future. These kids these days will never tell the difference. I'm a 67-year-old Hollywood producer, and even I can't tell the difference. Of course, you and I both know that that's total bullshit. Yet regardless of how we feel, movie producers will continue this trend because fuck you, you're gonna watch it. Now please understand that I'm not really shitting on CG at all, just the idea, or rather the misconception, that a realistic CGI character in a live action movie is somehow going to fool anyone or blend in better as opposed to cartoonier designs. You don't have to look far to find examples of movies who have blended in very well with cartoony characters, and yes, I understand that rendering a CG character in the real world is way easier than drawing a character every single frame, but you don't have to sacrifice design to fit the mold. Humans aren't stupid. We can easily identify a face and what's uncanny to us and all that junk. It's literally the one thing we're best at as opposed to other creatures. Well, that and genocide. Please don't demonetize me. It's easy to identify what is reality and what is fake in a movie. And yes, of course, when done well, it is nearly impossible to distinguish the two. And that's why CG is essential for most movies anyways. It helps add depth to a movie and allows the director to explore a world they otherwise would find it either impossible to explore or find it very expensive to explore. Yet when dealing with CG characters, well, that shit gets tricky. So tricky, in fact, that it stops being about fooling the audience into thinking that what they're seeing is really there, to just stylistically fitting to the thematics of the film. So in regard, it would have been better for the producers of the Sonic movie to not try and fool the audience into thinking that Sonic is really there, or that he truly blends into the real world, but rather make him more appealing and more faithful to the original design. And in return, we have a character that's much more charming and adoring to watch on screen. Does this mean Sonic should straight up Roger Rabbit this bitch and be a super cartoony render of himself? No, of course not. not. Because that would just probably be as jarring as him being hyper-realistic and having realistic proportions. Yet finding a balance between the two is very important. When people see this image, they see a disgusting rodent man creature, probably in a fursuit and been sweating all day, and he's probably not even the ethnicity you think he is. It's fucking shit. There's no polite way of saying it. Yet lately, people have been remaking the trailer screenshots and turning Sonic into a much more appealing looking character. That said, it's only fair to remember that these are only still images, and we can't determine if they would actually look good in motion. Just because it's appealing doesn't mean it'll work. What works out more than anything is Detective Pikachu's design from Detective Pikachu. Yeah. I talked about this already on my Medium article when I compared it with The Lion King, but to sum it up, Pikachu and all the other Pokemon work because they were bold decisions to revamp the Pokemon they're interpreting while staying faithful to the design. Yes, some of these don't really work out totally well, but for the most part, they seem to keep the characteristics of what made the original design memorable and great, serving as both homage to the source material and a complete revision for a new audience. The way this movie does it, however, spits at the face of Sonic and laughs at its tiny pee-pee. It is insulting. It is essentially redesigning the entirety of Sonic and making it seem like this version is better, like there's some fucking Tumblr poster. I don't know what they're called. Tumblr? I don't fucking know. There is no respect shown with this design, and a completely bastardization of what has worked in the past and what works today. This works, and so does this. This, however, is just... oh my god. It works because there are characteristics of this character. Jesus, that's redundant. There are things about this character that work. The color blue is very prominent, as is the color red to identify his feet, and his shoes being quite large actually identify the character and help the character's design model. The whole silhouette works, and the colors work, and the stocky body works, yet they did pretty much the exact opposite. The feet are smaller, the legs are longer, the body is just more human-like, and it doesn't seem as good. See, a stockier body makes it seem more charming, more adorable, and the eyes being the way they are serve as a sort of reminder that this character isn't just some cute, cuddly animal, he is a cocky kind of dude. It helps characterize who he is. Meanwhile, these soulless eyes, and I know that's a term used constantly, but Jesus Christ, these eyes don't really define him. They're just eyes. They don't really show any expression whatsoever. In fact, they look very plain. When Sonic is idle, there is nothing. There is no expression. There is no mood to him whatsoever. With the regular Sonic, the original Sonic, or any Sonic design, when he's just idle, you can see that there is expression. His eyes help define a sort of attitude that he wants to portray. That attitude being cool and rad and, I guess, a little bit badass. The long, uncanny proportions of his body really just make him look more like Slender Man than a character from a video game. The fucking dude is just, I can't get over the body. He is disgusting. Giving the character more human proportions just makes this way weirder than it should have been. Honestly, if he were just a cartoon character, that would be much more believable than if he were trying to emulate a human character. That only wants us to associate his proportions and his design to that of a human, which we all know humans know, they don't look anything like Sonic does. If he were more cartoony, at least our brains would tell us, hey, that's a cartoon, he's not supposed to be there. Hey, you're watching a movie, you actually don't need to give a fuck about what he looks like because he's just a cartoon rodent, it doesn't matter. But because he looks like this, it is a disturbing image, and the idea that he could be human or has human features, he has fucking human teeth, better than yours, probably. They are white and pearly. Jesus Christ, who is his dentist? That is concerning, and it is just disgusting to look at. Jesus Christ, get that out of here. Now, we could talk about the design all day long. We really can. But be wary of this. We're only talking about Sonic's model, his design in the movie. Whether Sonic looks good as shit or looks like the way he does now, the movie's plot will remain the same and it won't make a difference if he's good looking or not, because the movie could still suck. I remember seeing Arlo make a video on this and saying how he believes the movie producers know what they're doing. Well, actually, I didn't watch the video because his puppet freak thing just kind of creeps me out. It's
Yet I'm assuming his main argument was that they made him look as ugly as possible to get media buzz, and I agree with him. I know Hollywood is much smarter than we take them granted for, yet if I could play devil's advocate, meaning I'm an asshole who loves to argue for the sake of argument, then I would say this. Not all of Hollywood is full of conniving mastermind schemers. Sometimes they're just idiots who are out of touch. What I've said before convinces at least myself that Hollywood is on a path of CG destruction, in which they truly believe this is more appealing than this. I don't deny them coming up with schemes to look bad, only to get media buzz, but I also know that sometimes they think they know what they're doing when they're really just unaware and dissociated with modern crowds. I don't see them being totally unaware of Sonic's bad design, but I'm sure someone in the production team actually thinks this looks good. And that someone is probably the only reason why they're still making this film. Breaking news! Well, not actually breaking news, not anymore anyways.
Sorry about that. This video took a long time to edit. I don't know why.
Hey, guess what? The director of the film, Fowler, has told everyone that they're redesigning the movie due to outcry. Wow. I have very mixed feelings about this. Listen, as easy as it is to learn CG nowadays and with the tools given to creators to make their lives less miserable, it's still very difficult to create shit in a 3D space. Even reworking stuff is just as difficult. Keep in mind that this is a high-budgeted film that's coming out in 6 months. These kinds of films take years to pull off, and to ask your animators to rework this entire thing in just 6 months is unbelievably shitty. You're essentially treating them like sweatshirts. Shop workers. It's no wonder why people want unions in animation industries, because the precedent that this sort of film is setting is pretty much standard in most films nowadays. Yes, on one hand, it is very admirable to acknowledge your audience's outcry for your film, but on another, it's kind of evil to expect these folks to work overtime with no pay, I'm sure, because of your shitty movie. And listen, this is a very tricky situation for you guys, and I totally get that. It's a thing where you either satisfy everyone or satisfy no one, and then you're deciding, hey, we're gonna actually rework this. But for a lot of people, it seems like people don't really get what reworking an animated character means. It means a lot, and I mean a lot of work. So I guess if you really want to satisfy everyone, you should delay the movie. I think that'll be far more admirable, but I very much doubt that you guys will do that. This kind of makes me feel like that these guys really had no clue what they were doing in the first place. They seriously thought this was a good idea. So it's not a case of Hollywood being awful and bad for the sake of publicity. They legit thought this design was great. Now, because of their fuck-ups, they're cracking the whip on their animator boys, who I'm sure told the producers that they had better designs but got denied. Now they gotta fix this shit as fast as possible. Gotta animate fast. That's just dickish, honestly. Yeah, that's great, guys. Just ask all of your worthless animators behind the scenes to fix the problems. You should have seen these problems in the first place months ago when everyone was complaining about it, but hey, fuck you, why not? Just fuck it, whatever. While we're at it, why don't we just ask everyone involved in the movie to just do reshots? Or rewrite the whole movie? Oh wait, you won't do that? Oh, why? Is it probably because that's a lot of work and effort to ask from your high-paying actors? I don't know. Fucking Christ. Holy shit. Again, this is a very tricky situation. You're trying to satisfy the fans. Again, very admirable, but, you know, just think about the people who are working, also. I don't know, I'm making assumptions like I know what the work environment is like in that movie, but as far as I can tell, I know that people are trying to say it's a conspiracy. They made it look bad because that's just how the way it was, so we could all talk about it. Maybe, but I seriously think you guys are overseeing this. Like you're overestimating how Hollywood works. I don't think they saw that far in the future, okay? The more likely scenario is that the people who are paid to make animation and learn how to animate and learn cartoon and character design and are paid to do that shit for the fucking rest of their lives, I'm sure they're the ones who came up with some pretty cool, innovative ideas to actually implement into this movie so that fucking Sonic doesn't look like a stupid-ass gerbil. The more likely story is that, yes, they gave him all those good ideas, but then, hey, a guy in a suit was like, this is too cartoony. No, we need something more serious and edgy. Yo, get Jim Carrey on the phone, motherfucker. Fuck off. Thank you all so very much for watching. I'll see y'all next time. I love y'all so much. Goodbye.